Hello, my name is Thomas. I'm a member of Technical Support Department here in Prague in ComAp headquarters. And in this video, I would like to show you where you can find information about ECU support in ComAp units and how to configure it in our controllers. This window is GenConfig, our software configuration tool for IntelliGen, IntelliSys and IntelliMains NT units. And you can see that I have chosen IntelliSys NT-CBB unit in SPTM configuration, and I would like to use Scania S6 ECU on this one. So I can navigate to our website, find IntelliSys within our products, and there's the IntelliSys NTC base box. And here in the section of manuals, I can find the electronic engine support guide. That's the most important document that you will need regarding ECU support. I can click on this one, and if I click on this link, I will download it. So now I need to find the comparison table, which is on page 24. And I will need to check whether this ECU is supported or not. So I can see that IntelliSys NT is the first one in the table. And now I need to find Scania S6. And I can see it's here and it's supported. I can see that this cell is filled with white color, so I can check again what does it mean. And I can see that the ECU is supported, but there is no after treatment support for Scania S6 ECU. So that was just the comparison table. If I want to find details of this particular ECU, I would need to find it in this document. I can either go through the table of contents and find the Scania ECUs, or I do remember that this one is on page 228, and I can easily navigate there. You can see what engine types are typically used for these ECU types. So I can see that S6 single speed is used on those, DC9, 12, DC16, and so on. And here in this table, I can see all the inputs and outputs and parameters available. So those were controller inputs, those are controller outputs. I can see the analogs as well. Those are values measured by the ECU that the controller can read. Those are inputs again. And then there are controller's outputs. That's, for example, for speed adjustment. So all these parameters are here mentioned with their SPN. If you need to find out SPN in terms of fault codes, you can navigate to the fault codes page, which is also a part of the manual. So here in the ECU support guide, you can find out what ECUs are supported and what parameters are supported per each ECU and what fault codes are translated in our units. Then you can download the latest ECU list. So if I close the manual section, I can open software section and I can see that there is ECU list 7.2.1. I can either download it from here or I can go to the support page and ask the bot for the latest ECU list in the download files section. See, I got the same. There is the new feature list, which I could download also from the manuals section. And there is the latest ECU list, which if I download, I will be able to import it. For import, I need to close GenConfig. And I'll open it again then. So this is my downloaded ECU list. I can double click on it and ComAp firmware importer will open. I can press OK. And this ECU list was just imported into your library. This library is just in your computer, it's not yet in the controller itself. So from this IntelliMonitor, I can open GenConfig with the IS-NTC-BB configuration again that was closed before. And now I can see this is my configuration that I have shown you in the beginning of the video. There is again IntelliSys NT-CBB, and after the import you can see that there is ECU list all speed 7.2.1. But I don't want to use all speed, I would like to use single speed. So I can go to options, ESL files, and I can choose the ECU list for gensets, which means single speed. I can press OK. And I would need to restore GenConfig again. So GenConfig has been restarted. You can see that I have ECU list for gensets 7.2.1, which is the one that I have downloaded from the website. So if I want to choose the ECU, I can open this ECU list here. I can scroll down to see Scania, and I can choose the ECU I wanted to use. So the ECU is now configured. I can choose the ECU size. I can choose what will happen upon module failure. This means if the communication is lost, whether I would like to have first level or second level protection or no protection at all. I can choose whether I would like to add screens of all the ECU values available onto our displays, and I can choose whether I would like to display this data just as numbers or bar graphs. You can see that there is a small hint for which engines this ECU is typically used. You can double click on this image and you can see the detail of how this is wired. So this is just the configuration of ECU to have it in the IntelliSys NT-CBB. But I can also go to inputs and outputs, and I can check all the inputs and outputs in the ECU group here, as I would do it for standard physical inputs and outputs. So here I can choose what ECU value is used, and I can process it in the way that we are used to with standard inputs and outputs, to connect functions and protections and so on. So there is a group of 16 inputs and outputs. I can choose which ECU value is used and what does it mean in our unit. I can do the same for binary outputs, which are signals from the control unit to the ECU. All those are standardly used based on the parameters I have shown you in the ECU support guide. So I can click on the ECU binary output number one. I can see that within our unit, logical zero function is used, and I can choose what ECU value this is used for. So inputs means communication from the ECU to the control unit. Outputs means from the control unit to the ECU. I can do the same with outputs. If I open outputs window, you can see that there is a speed request. This is the most important settings for speed adjustment. So the control unit is sending speed request value to ECU value, which is called nominal speed offset, both in percentage. You can always check this in the ECU support guide. What is the recommended settings for speed adjustment for each ECU for those control units? So this is how to set it up. Then of course, as in GenConfig always, you need to write it into the unit using this red button. And then if it is properly configured, and if there is any alarm from the ECU, you would see it in the alarm list with blue background, also on the display. So this was how to find the information, how to configure it, what will it do when there is an alarm. If you have ECU that is not mentioned in the ECU support guide, you can always reach us on support@comap-control.com. It would ask you for the documentation, and if it is widely used ECU, we can implement it. Thank you for your attention, and see you at the next video.